Our women have been going missing and being murdered for so long.
We're talking about Indigenous women who are some of the most marginalized people in our country. We really need to not stereotype them, to be seen as individuals, as real people, will really make an impact on violence against women.
For a people that are born in injustice, raised in injustice, see injustice all the time, almost every day, for generations of injustice, how then do we find and seek justice in a society that doesn't see it? We're entering into a critical phase now that the inquiry has begun to address the traumas that are going to be re-triggered. Colonization has taught us one thing, is that not only can we survive just about anything, we can heal from just about anything.
Our people have been through so much trauma, and that's what we want to get at, is healing the trauma. Natsimat means one heart, one mind, living in a good way.
The biggest job that I see for us as VACPC in our work with community is reconnecting.
We have all these social issues that we're dealing with, but we have a lot of people who are in their recovery and healing and who are going into their culture. I'm absolutely amazed by the resilience and inner strength of our Indigenous community.
We use as many different cultural aspects as we can, whether it's the smudge, whether it's medicine wheel teachings, tree of life, sweat lodge, drumming and singing. What we've learned over the years is that every single person needs a different type and level of support. Culture is the best medicine.
Through culture, through art, through family gatherings, that's the kind of support that really helps family to open up.
There's just so many things that need to happen all together to start the healing journey.
All our staff is familiar with and has training in Aboriginal focusing oriented therapy, which is very cultural approach to trauma.
We've done some Cedar weaving workshops, getting to know our cultures that way.
So there are thousands of good ways of bringing back culture. And they're all healing.
Thank you for coming. Get as much weaving done as we can. The one on the right, I'm folding down. One on the left is gonna go over this one and under this one.
My hope for Natsimat is to heal as many families as we can. I know that when we start with one family member, it expands to other family members, and families start healing together. And they're able to help others.
You got it. She's got it, so she's good.
We run programs which end. But if we can teach people the skills of reconnecting with each other and helping each other, then they don't need us anymore eventually.
I started Butterflies in Spirit to get my missing aunt's picture out there to honor my cousin Tanya Holick.
To honor my auntie, Georgina Papin.
We started healing together, raising awareness of this issue.
We incorporated some traditional dance into our group. We didn't necessarily grow up knowing a lot about our culture, so it kind of forced all of us to talk to family, relatives, go on YouTube, learn those traditional dances.
I didn't realize how healing dance is.
Another part of our piece is singing the Women's Warrior Song. We prayed, put that good energy into the drum, because I know that that drum is gonna be used for a ceremony and send a powerful message.
This song, the Women's Warrior Song, is a song that Martina and Pierre shared with us. It's a song to be sung for strength, never to be sung in anger. It's a song that empowers, it's a song that unites, and we're grateful to be able to sing this song.
It's going to be a challenge, this inquiry. It's going to trigger a lot of hurt and a lot of bad memories for a lot of people. The inquiry is not going to make them healthier, stronger. The government is not going to make them healthier, stronger. We ourselves are going to make each other healthier and stronger. So this whole reconciliation movement and this whole inquiry into a giant injustice are opportunities to create a different public perspective on those issues.
when you open yourself up to that healing, you see the transformation in people, and you say, yes. When the time comes, we're there to support. And I'm really hoping that with the inquiry that that's what happens.